Flagship film from Oppo, the Oppo Reno. So really excited to see what this phone is offering, and just look at the box. It looks so different compared to any other phone box that I have unboxed this year. So we've got the Oppo Reno text along with the design print. So it's got three colors, but I got this one in the green one. So taking off the plastic, beautiful look, and time to release the shark fin beauty. Wow, look at this tall look. I mean, very different, very unique. First comes the paperwork, of course, so let's just bring this out. You can see Oppo along with all the guide that is in Chinese, I believe. And here we have the phone itself. Wow, turning it around. I'm not gonna remove the plastic yet because we're gonna take a look at the accessories first, like always. So first up, we have a protective case out of the box. This is obviously designed to, you know, protect this movable camera system design of the Oppo Reno. Now we also get Oppo VOOC fast charger out of the box, which is looking pretty powerful, and also has a special USB type cable which has this VOOC branding as well. And then we have very beautiful looking earbuds, and you can notice that they are actually green, which is a nice touch. The phone is in green color, the cable has this green texture, the earphone has the green color. I mean, it just makes everything perfect. Okay, it's time to take off the plastic off this beautiful bad boy and take a look at this beauty. Now, it might seem like a blue color, but I assure you it is a dark green color, and it just feels so damn premium from the back. It's really hard to, you know, stand out with so many smartphone designs, but Oppo has definitely think through when that is absolutely incredible. Okay, so just got done with the setup, and you can see the beautiful design with the Oppo Reno, a completely bezel-less display. And obviously, to achieve this beautiful bezel-less design, they had to make some sacrifices, and which is, of course, the movable camera system. This is a bit different compared to their older Oppo Find X design. So this is called as shark fin camera. It has a really, really cool look to it. And again, guys, I'm not gonna lie, it looks really incredible. Of course, if you're thinking about buying a phone with a movable camera system, you should be very careful that you don't drop this phone in water. If you do that, then chances are that it might not survive. And you can see side by side with the Galaxy S10 Plus, it definitely looks really, really premium. However, for the ultra premiumness, I do realize that we got to have the edge display, because this just puts everything into a new premium zone. But Reno is hands down looking as one of the best bezel-less phones I've ever owned. Now, the Oppo Reno actually comes in two variants. So this one is the Qualcomm Snapdragon 710 variant. There is the Qualcomm 855 version as well. So this particular model has a 6.4 inch display instead of 6.6 inch of the bigger model, and it is still AMOLED, looks really, really sharp. Now with this bezel-less display, you also get an optical fingerprint scanner, which in my usage has been the fastest one that I've tried so far. It just unlocks instantly. Now software wise is rocking the Android 9.0 Pie, and throughout the UI everything looks very similar and inspired by iOS, especially with the notification panel. You can see this is just very, very similar to how iOS looks. But of course, since it's Android, you get a lot of customization apart from just looking like iOS. So you have the effects here that allows you to change your animation when you swipe around. You can change your icons layout, set app sharkers, and even set a theme, which is something you don't get on iOS, obviously. So in my opinion, they should make their skin look more like Android, but maybe this is what that's popular in China. So now this version has only two cameras towards the back. So you get the 48 megapixel main camera sensor, which is similar to the Oppo Reno Snapdragon 855 model, and then there's a secondary 5 megapixel for depth sensing. It also has 2x zoom. What you lose on is, of course, the 10x zoom that you get on the higher price model, as well as the wide angle lens. So this one is cheaper. You get the same design, but the cameras do definitely differ a lot. But if you're not gonna take zoom pictures, I think it's pretty much the same camera setup. And as far as the images are concerned, I definitely feel like Oppo is doing great here. Their dynamic range is pretty good, the colors are nice, and it even has this nightscape or night mode that works pretty good when it has to work when you're using it in a really dark environment, and just overall images turns out to be really good. You can record 4K videos. Now instead of 10 times zoom, you only get 2x zoom, and if you want to zoom all the way 10x, you can still do that, but obviously you will lose the quality. Now as for the front camera, it is rocking 16 megapixels, so again, I'm not a huge fan of the skin tones, but it is what it is. Now despite having a beautiful thin design, this phone is still rocking a 3700 mAh battery, and combined with Qualcomm Snapdragon 710 chip, you should be able to get one day of usage out of it without any problem. So thank you so much for watching this video. A quick unboxing tour of the Oppo Reno looks incredible design-wise. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. And subscribe to the channel if you're new here. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.